The scale of justice will be broke before man. Now you shall have to explain your whole lifespan.
Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh. Brothers and sisters in Islam, welcome back to the inevitable journey. Before the break, we talked about the condition of those people, the people who will be living in the face of this earth when the hour will occur. Something that is so shocking. In spite of this, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam and the hadith fi sunan al-Tirmidhi wa sunan Abi Dawood, hadith Abi Sa'id al-Khudri radiyallahu anhu, was so concerned that the hour will happen while he is part of those people. Because I know a lot of us sitting and listening and watching right now and saying, I don't belong to those people. I don't belong to those people. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the more knowledge you have about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, the more concerned, the more insecure you become. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, أَنَا أَعْلَمُكُمْ بِاللَّهِ وَأَشَدُّكُمْ لَهُ خَشْيَةً. I am the most knowledgeable of you, of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And at the same time, I am the most fearful amongst you of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala said, إِنَّمَا يَخْشَى اللَّهَ مِنْ عِبَادِهِ الْعُلَمَاءِ. Indeed, the people of knowledge are the people who are the most fearful of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, كَيْفَ أَنْعَمْ. How can I enjoy this life? And that is why in some cases he would come to the companions and tells them, لو علمتم ما أعلم لضحكتم قليلا ولبكيتم كثيرا. If I know that which I know, you will cry more than you're laughing, brothers and sisters in Islam. And that is why this world for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was nothing. This dunya for the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam was nothing. Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu anhu, one day entered while he was asleep in a mat, basically a piece of hard cloth or a piece of hard wood that he sleeps on that printed in his body. And he said, Ya Rasulallah, shouldn't we have brought you something softer than this? Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells Abdullah ibn Mas'ud radiyallahu an, mali wa dunya, mali wa dunya, what is me and the dunya, what is me and the dunya, what is me and the dunya. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam tells you that if this dunya equals a wing of a mosquito in the sight of Allah, he would not have given a kafir a drink of water. And the hadith في سنن الترمذي ومسند الإمام أحمد من حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما. This is the dunya, brothers and sisters in Islam, in the sight of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. But again, this dunya will be beneficial, this world will be beneficial if you designate it to make you inherit the comfort on the day of resurrection and the comfort in Jannah insha'Allah. Brothers and sisters in Islam, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, how can I enjoy this world when the bearer of the horn of the trumpet, كيف أنعم وقد التقم صاحب القرن القرن وحنى جبهته وأصغى سمعه. The angel who's in charge of blowing in the trumpet is holding the horn, the trumpet, and his ear is tentative, listening to the command of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, to the command to come from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and his eyes are at the throne, focused on the throne of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. In some wording of this hadith, his eyes are like two stars, huge stars, كأنهما كوكبين ذريين. The two eyes of the angel who is holding that book, that horn, he is staring, he does not blink. He's afraid to blink because least Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala would command him to blow in the trumpet while he is not paying attention. Look at the reaction of the companions, brothers and sisters in Islam, once they heard this from the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. فَثَقُلَ ذَلِكَ عَلَىٰ أَصْحَابِ النَّبِيِّ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمْ. Once they heard this, the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam felt it so heavy, they could not handle it. Rasul sallallahu alayhi wa sallam told them, قُولُوا حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ حَسْبُنَ اللَّهُ وَنِعْمَ الْوَكِيلِ عَلَى اللَّهِ تَوَكَّلْنَا عَلَىٰ رَبِّنَا تَوَكَّلْنَا. Allah will be all sufficient for us. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will take a good care of us. Then we place our trust in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Brothers and sisters in Islam, في مسند الإمام أحمد حديث عبد الله بن عمر رضي الله عنهما, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, من سره أن ينظر إلى قيام الساعة أو إلى يوم القيامة رأي عين فليقرأ إذا الشمس كورت وإذا السماء انفطرت وإذا السماء انشقت. Whoever wishes to visualize the events that will happen when Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala decrees for this beautiful world that the people are fighting over it to be destroyed and to be gone, that does not exist anymore. Read, إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ. When the sun is shrouded with darknesses, we know the sun gives light. The sun will be shrouded with darknesses, with darkness. No more light coming out of the sun. وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ انْكَدَرَتْ. And when the stars that are bright are extinguished from their light. انتثرت, it will be scattered. الرسول صلى الله عليه وسلم in a hadith أبي موسى الأشعري في صحيح مسلم, in it he said, والنجوم أمنة السماء فإذا ذهبت النجوم أتى السماء ما توعد. The stars are the security for the heaven, and when the stars will be scattered, then the heaven, the sky will crumble. Brothers and sisters in Islam, وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ انْكَدَرَتْ. إِذَا الشَّمْسُ كُوِّرَتْ وَإِذَا النُّجُومُ انْكَدَرَتْ وَإِذَا الْجِبَالُ سُيِّرَتْ. His huge terrain of mountains will walk. وَتَرَى الْجِبَالَ تَحْسَبُهَا جَامِدَةً. And you would look at the mountains, you would think that it is not moving, you would think that it is not moving. وَهِيَ تَمُرُّ مَرَّ السَّحَابِ. But thus the mountains will be moving like the clouds. كالعهن المنفوش. The mountains will be like wool that is scattered all over the place. ويسألونك عن الجبال. And they ask you, O Muhammad, about the mountains. فقل ينسفها ربي نسفا فيذرها قاعا صفصفا لا ترى فيها عوجا ولا أمتا. They ask you about the mountains, O Muhammad. Tell them, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will turn it into dust. You will not see in it a place that is high, a place that is low, equal to earth, brothers and sisters in Islam. وَإِذَا الْعِشَارُ عُطِّلَتْ. And when the most expensive camels that the Arabs loved so much, pregnant, anuq, pregnant camels, the female camels, when they are not being taken care of, the people are careless of their wealth, the people are careless of their property and what they own, they don't care about it anymore, brothers and sisters in Islam. You will not pay attention to your money, you will not pay attention to your skyscrapers, you will not pay attention to your car. وَإِذَا الْبِحَارُ سُجِّرَتْ. And when the sea will turn into fire, the sea that is filled with water will turn into fire. وَإِذَا النُّفُوسُ زُوِّجَتْ. And when the souls will be coupled. وَإِذَا الْمَوْءُودَةُ سُئِلَتْ بِأَيِّ ذَنْبٍ قُتِلَتْ. Brothers and sisters in Islam, Look at the reaction of mankind to this state of drunkenness. يا أيها الناس, O mankind, اتقوا ربكم. There will be a huge earthquake in earth. إن زلزلة الساعة شيء عظيم. These days, once we hear in the news, an earthquake that is 6 point whatever, according to the measurement of whatever, look at the quake of the hour, will make people in a state of drunkenness. يوم ترونها تذهل كل مرضعة عما أرضعت. A woman who's suckling her baby will throw away her baby. A woman who's pregnant will drop her load. وترى الناس سكارى وما هم بسكارى ولكن عذاب الله شديد. You will see people in a state of drunkenness, but they are not drunk, but the punishment of Allah سبحانه وتعالى is severe. Look at the kafirs, look at the disbelievers, the people who would not want the hour will come. They are questioning. ويقولون متى هذا الوعد إن كنتم صادقين. They say, when this will happen? When? Look. ما ينظرون إلا صيحة واحدة تأخذهم وهم يخصمون. They are only waiting for one blast that will overtake them while they are disputing, while they are talking, selling and buying. لا يستطيعون توصية ولا إلى أهلهم يرجعون. They will not even have time to leave a will, nor they will return to their family members. Brothers and sisters in Islam, get ready for this day. Insha'Allah, we will continue with the inevitable journey, unfolding what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and what the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam informed us regarding this day. Assalamu alaikum wa rahmatullahi wa barakatuh.
The scale of justice will be brought before man. Now you shall have to explain your whole lifespan. What you did in the open and what you conceived. From big to small shall today be revealed. Your deeds shall then be waiting. Shall determine if you pass or fail. Heaven and hell shall be brought into vision. Allah alone shall make the ultimate decision. To all brothers and sisters, I'd like to say. Ask for forgiveness and do that too.